how do you get out of your comfort zone?
Or I'm why coming is... out.
Sige.
Okay.
Hey. Hello everyone. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Welcome to 2019.
Yes, and we hope that you had a very, very successful 2000
New Year celebration.
Oh, and 2018 for the year, 2018, no? 2018. Diba? At least you're step closer to your financial goals.
Yeah.
If not, nod lang kayo ng videos natin.
Yes. And a lot of people right now, they're talking about New Year's resolution, financial goals, etc.
Oh, isa sa mga resolution kapag New Year is ano, no? I'll go back to the gym.
Lose weight.
Or
save more money.
Na January lang daw maraming tao sa gym. Kasi pagdating ng Feb, wala na raw.
Wala na. Ano, from experience, I can say that's true.
Totoo.
But anyway, for today, we're going to talk about a related topic, which is how do you get out of your comfort zone?
Or I'm coming out.
Sige, tuloy mo yan. Yan ba ang goal mo for 2019? Why is it important or why is it beneficial to get out of your comfort zone? Kasi I believe na
I believe.
Ako kasi kung meron kang mga financial goals or you want to change habits or you want to stop your bad habits or you want to start a good habit, one of the things that you need to do
start
is
start doing and stop doing.
Diba? And it requires you to go out of your comfort zone. Pag
yung
ganun, eh,
kinasanayan mo na.
Oo.
Parang dolphin lang nga sa kano, sumalangit pa, tinatagalog.
Sino? Hindi ko gets yung ginagawa mo.
Ay, pari.
Getting out of the comfort zone. No? So, ano ba ang definition ng comfort zone
yung,
para sa'yo?
Kung saan ka komportable,
mm-hmm,
yung nakagawian mo na. Yan. Uh-oh. Or nakaugalian mo na everyday, day in and day out, sila lang yung ginagawa mo.
So, minsan, kunwari, medyo magastos ka, hindi ka nakapag-save.
Mm-hmm.
Kahit na mag-resolve ka na magsisave ka na ng mas maraming
hindi
pera,
mo nagagawa.
Hindi mo siya nagagawa kasi katulad nung sinabi natin na sa umpisa, masigasig, no? Very motivated.
Ninas kugon.
Pero eventually,
nawawala
because
bumabalik.
Kasi they are trying to get out of their comfort zone and start a new habit. Pero eventually, human response yun, na masyadong mahirap. Huwag na lang.
Kumbaga,
babalik ka sa
medyo
dati.
Medyo may konting effort na, parang medyo mahirap na, di ba? So, balik tayo sa dati.
Nagsisimula sa next time na lang.
O bukas na lang.
Bukas na lang.
So, sick na lang.
So, ano bang mga pwede nating tips, no?
Na mas, to go out of your comfort zone.
If you want to get out of your comfort zone and change for the better. Di ba? Sabi nga nila, new year, new me. Kaya. Marami akong nakikitang ganyan. I'm ready for 2019. And
I'm so ready.
Being ready means being able to know or have strategies on how to break through that comfort zone mo.
Yes,
no?
Break free. Like Ariana
Ikaw ba?
Branding.
Ano bang ginagawa mo pag if you're trying to
ako?
Start something new?
Ako, siguro I related sa yung pag-lose ko ng weight.
Oo.
Hindi, kasi dati talaga super taba ako, diba? 176 pounds ako, so I lost 40 pounds in 3 years. Ako is, number one is really yung desire ko to be healthy. So, kumbaga, it started with my desire.
Yeah, but why?
Strong why. Apart from the desire is also syempre gusto ko maging healthy, gusto ko ayoko magkaroon ng sakit sa puso, ma stroke, etc. And apart from that, meron akong parang vision ng sarili ko na okay, ganito ako ngayon, size 36, tapos excellent damit ko. Pero kumbaga, if I do all of this healthy eating, tapos healthy lifestyle, tapos regularly going to gym, then meron akong magiging ganito ako. So that keeps me motivated and keeps me up in the morning. And sa financial goals ko rin, ganun, kumbaga, ito yung gusto kong bili na kotse. Dito ko gusto bumili ng bahay at magtayo ng bahay at lupa. So kumbaga, although wala akong yung mga tinatawag na vision board, but it's always part of my head.
So it's important if you want to get out of your comfort zone and be able to break through that barrier is to have a strong why. And ako, I believe na your vision is not just having a healthy body. But the higher reason there is, of course, you want to live a long life to spend yes. with your family, di ba?
Gusto mo magkasakit, magkasakit?
Gusto mo makita yung family mo, yung anak mo na magka-asawa, mag-anak, or magka-apo, di ba?
So, play with them.
And of course, you're working hard now to make money. Ayaw mong maubos lahat ng pera mo sa pagpapagamot mo. No? So I think that's your stronger reason.
So
no?
Everything of that, kumbaga, that's my pull. Actually, that pulls me to do all of these things. So for example, mga sacrifices, mga pagtitipid para, ay nako, hindi mo nakagastos ito kasi pinag-iipunan ako. Or, ay nako, next year target ko pumunta ng out of the country. So instead na bumili ako ng ganito, then iipunin ko na kasi mas importante sa akin.
Yes. So it's important to have a vision or a strong reason why you are doing this and remind yourself that.
Every day yon.
Yes, yes.
Every day.
And that's why yung paggawa ng vision board or writing down your goal works for a lot of people because it's a reminder for them kung bakit ko ba to ginagawa.
That's true. And dagdag ko din doon, every morning, okay, of course sa iPhone, I play mga motivational videos. Like, alimbawa, habang nagsisipilyo. Ayun, habang nagpo-floss ng ipin, habang nagsisipilyo, ay, nakalagay lang yung iPhone doon, tapos i-select sa motivational video. So, habang nagsisipilyo, nagpo-floss,
nagma-mindset ka.
Oo, no? Nagtotoner ako. Ganyan. Ay, alam na nila yung ano ko.
Meron ka talagang morning
naglalagay ng sunblock.
Beauty routine.
Yan. Eh, kesa naman walang, kesa kung ano-ano tumatakbo. So, kumbaga, yung input sa utak ko are motivational videos. Tapos habang nabibiyes. So, kung di pa tapos yung video habang nagsisipilyo, habang nagbibiyes, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung motivational videos. So, every morning yon para to prime me up.
Ako naman, ang usual na ginagawa ko, if I'm trying to work for a specific goal, I try to set mga easy to reach benchmarks, no?
Oh, easy to reach.
So, for example, I want to buy a car. Let's
okay. So, gulong muna.
Oh. Gulong muna or ano muna?
Manibela.
You of course, 'di ba, meron ka dapat measurable goal, no? So, for example, I want to buy a 1 million peso na worth ng car. Mm. So, instead of thinking na gusto ko ng 1 million,
okay.
I start with, sige, magsisave muna ako ng down payment.
Oh.
So, which is what? Actually, 200,000, di ba? And more than that, 200,000, pwede ko pa siyang ma-break down into a further goal na 50,000 muna. The first 50,000.
Oh.
So, I want to save it or I want to earn that so right. that I can work. So, hindi siya masyadong nakaka-
Overwhelm.
Mo.
So, yun,
yung pag-go out mo of the- Kasi, siyempre, that will entail me to lessen my lower my spending or trying to find more sources of income. Yun yung uncomfortable eh na nagtitipid
right.
ka
Uh-oh.
No? Pero kasi if you set benchmarks or mga easy to achieve goals,
mga baby steps, mga
mo,
milestones.
Once na achieve mo 'yon, meron kang boost of confidence and motivation.
Na kaya mo pala.
Oo. So you slowly go out of your comfort zone. So just be persistent with your efforts.
May naalala nga ako na parang kwento, parang how do you eat an elephant daw?
One bite at a time.
Diba? Hindi mo kakainin yung elephant ng buo. So chop-chop lang, one bite at a time. And I believe magandang strategy yan kasi hindi ka ma-overwhelm, nabanggit niya natin kanina, saka hindi ka ma-frustrate.
Yes,
kasi
yes.
Kasi ba, naku, 25,000 pala yung natatabi ko, layo pa sa 1 million.
Yes, oo.
Diba? So parang frustrate ka na, ay, ayoko na mag-ipon kasi layo-layo pa.
Minsan, na-demotivate ka.
Okay yun ha, tama yun ha. Ano pa mga
strategy? Sa akin, ka? If you really want to change, if you're changing a bad habit, sa akin, it's easier to replace a bad habit. So, if you have a bad habit, sabihin natin na magastos ka,
okay.
Every time na pupunta ka sa mall, nagiging impulsive yung kasab bumili. So, it's a bad habit that you want to change.
Okay.
So, instead of just telling yourself na I will stop impulse buying, you replace it with a better habit. No, actually, I'm speaking from experience kasi dati, pag pupunta ka sa mall, I get so impulsive minsan, I buy... May kasi ako sa walking shorts, sa shirts, no? So sabi ko, instead of me trying to control myself na mag-impulse buying, why not change my habit of going to the department store, change it and make it a habit of going to the bookstore. So,
gumaganong ka?
Oo. So, pagdating sa bookstore, sometimes, especially some bookstores, you are allowed to actually read.
Oh, yeah.
So, you don't have to buy already, no? Oo. Ako, pag may nakita ako na libro na talagang very interesting, I think it's very informative, doon ko na lang sina-channel yung pagiging impulse buying ko.
So, you're channeling your energy. Oo.
So, you replace your bad habits with a better habit, no? Mm-hmm. So, yung iba kong kakilala na mahilig kumain ng mga unhealthy foods or junk food, no?
Oh, ano kinakain?
So, ang ginagawa niya, kasi syempre, you have junk food at home, when you feel like you want to have a snack, yun yung nagiging, ano. So, ang ginagawa niya, nireplace niya yung pagbili niya ng junk food with healthy snacks. So, hindi niya directly deal yung unhealthy eating niya.
So, may substitute.
May substitute.
Substitute. Kumbaga, dati, potato chip siya. Ngayon, ano na lang, mga...
Peanuts or
mga mushroom.
Anong mushroom?
Yung mushroom chips.
Ay, yung mga ganon. Yeah, pwede.
Taro chips. Sarap yun.
Taro chips. Yun, alam mo yun? So, you're replacing it. It's not just... You're not completely stopping a specific habit. You're replacing it with something better
or better healthier. Habit.
Oh, kasi mas madaling ma-overcome yung challenge pag ganon.
Totoo nga naman. Ako, meron akong dagdag.
At saka, sabi pala ng scientific studies, it takes 66 days to...
66?
To change a habit. So
2 months.
More or less 2 months, no? Or sabihin na natin 3 months para sigurado. So, yung habit na gusto nilang i-establish, you just have to be consistent and persistent for 3 months and eventually it will become automatic na sa'yo.
May nabasa akong ganyan. Parang one of those American authors, parang habit daw, if you do it every day, is like parang building a rope from small threads such that when you build from those small threads, it's really strong enough na hindi mo na siya mabe-break.
Yeah.
So, little by little.
So, yun yung, kasi may mga nagsasabi 14 days, etc. Ang pakita sa research, around 66 days. So, ako, usually,
2-3 months.
When I'm trying to build a new routine into my activity, daily activities, I just tell myself, kasi yung iba iniisip na magtitipid na ako for the whole year. Di ba? So, why not just change your mindset na
like, for 1 week?
For hanggang March, kailangan kong magtipid. Okay? So, I will...
So, parang, you make it bite-sized.
Yes, So,
baby steps.
Pag dumating yung March at you've been successful at saving money, I'm very sure saving money has already become a habit for them na continuing it pagdating ng April, May, June will be much easier. Totoo. Kesa yung sinabi mo na magbabago na ako for the whole 2019, hindi na ako magiging magastos. It's so overwhelming, di ba? Keeping in mind that learning a new habit takes around 66 days. So, just be consistent with that habit for that amount of time.
Parang
and then
ano,
it becomes easier.
Parang on top of that, no? Parang ako dati, nung malakas pa ako kumain, 1.5 rice. Tapos ngayon, no rice na talaga ako. Tapos my friends are asking me, how did you do that? Sabi ko, simple lang, parang glide approach. Sabi ko, halimbawa, kung dati nakaka 1.5 ako ng cup ng rice, so next week, babawas ako na ng 1/4. Or tapos, so 1/4 na lang. Mm-hmm. Tapos the week after, 1 na lang. Tapos the week after, so paunti-unti lang siya. Tapos syempre, papalitan ko lang ng ulam or other healthy alternative.
Yun,
tapos before I know it, wala nang rice. So kumbaga, para siyang glide path na parang yun nga, paunti-unti.
Yeah, pero I believe that, some people, it works na paunti-unti. Some people it works na abrupt.
Cold turkey.
Abrupt change. So find the strategy that works for you.
Yes.
Okay? The important thing is you are trying and even if you fail, alam mo yon, you just continue, just be persistent and of course it's hard at sa simula, pero just stick to it for at least 3 months. And you'll notice na
kaya mo pala.
Mas dumadali siya. So you just have to commit 2 to 3 months. No? Oo. So that's how you really break out of your comfort zone and improve your life for 2019.
Yes.
Okay? So yun, no? So very mindsetting ang ating...
Oo, dahil new year, new me, new thinking, new you.
Yeah, well, because a lot of financial goals...
mindset talaga.
Yeah, it requires mindset. A lot of smart money habits start with the proper mindset.
Yes.
Proper behavior, financial behavior.
Of course.
Okay? So I hope you learned something new from this video.
Yes.
Please give it a thumbs up if you like it. And share it to your friends.
If you have comments, drop on the comment section.
Type lang kayo. And if you have topics that you want us to discuss, you just email us at admin@wealthmarketing.com. And please subscribe to our channel.